नमस्ते, माय नेम इज JVN ऋषि गौतम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मास कम्युनिकेशन जर्नलिज्म। टुडेज टॉपिक इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन मास कम्युनिकेशन एंड पर्सनल कम्युनिकेशन। द मोस्ट बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन मास कम्युनिकेशन एंड पर्सनल कम्युनिकेशन इज द साइज ऑफ द ऑडियंस and the source of the masses, by which we mean that in personal communication, the sender as well as the receiver is a person, while in mass communication, the sender as well as the receiver may be a person, a group, or a huge chunk of population of a country. The other important difference between them is the reason why the masses actually originated and the conditions under which it is being communicated. For instance, in personal communication, the expression of certain emotions could be a reason which in mass communication it might be to include the audience of the masses to buy or try a product or service. The tools, or rather the medium in both, are also different. Mass communication will have print, audiovisual, internet, etc., but personal communication will have mobile, mail, or internet as a tool to communicate. How does mass communication affect culture? Culture refers to the attributes such as lifestyle, habits, and moral ethics that a population in a specific place might adhere to, as the way of life, it's ever changing and in subject to influences. This is where the mass communication can have an effect on the culture, ethos of a society. Communicating on a mass level gives the sender of a message the power to alter certain things or introduce new things that might affect the cultural dynamics of a society, and it can't happen in isolation. Every individual part of that culture is subject to the ramification. For instance, coffee and coffee shops have never been a part of the Indian culture, but today, due to the idea being promoted in every medium of mass communication, it has almost become a part of it. This example demonstrates how culture is affected by mass communication and ultimately altered. Media literacy, media as place in ideas, media convergence, media consolidation. Media literacy refers to the act of creating a masses in all the available media. It uses an inquiry-based mode of process, encouraging questions about what the target audience wants in terms of what they watch, see, and read. Media literacy facilitates an understanding as to the strengths and limitations of each medium and to create new ones. Media as place of ideas. Media as place of ideas is a metaphor to help think of ideas in a medium as products or receipts that are produced, imported, and shared by community members. Ideas have value and cost, which can be registered and protected in the form of patents. trademarks and copyrights. Ideas also have opportunity, distribution and production costs. Media convergence. Media convergence refers to many products coming together to form one. In media convergence, old and new media merge in such a way that there is a balance of power between media producers and media consumers, and ultimately results into a brand new scenario of operations. Media consolidation. Media consolidation refers to the majority of the media means owned by a few media conglomerates who view this as detrimental and characterized ownership structure of mass media. Media ownership may refer to monopoly in a given media. Times Group in India is an example of a media conglomerate. Thank you.